This is Jhanna Gujjar, Assistant Professor at ITICT Department of LJ Institute of Engineering and Technology. Welcome to the 7th lecture of Unit 3. In previous lecture, we have learned about a software project estimation in which we have learned about empirical estimation model. We have discussed about COCOMO model. Okay, there are three types: organic, semi-detached and embedded. And we have also discussed that there are three stages of COCOMO model. So first stage is basic COCOMO model. Basic COCOMO model is already discussed in the previous lecture. So in today's lecture, we will continue with the COCOMO model, in which we will learn about the intermediate COCOMO model and the detailed COCOMO model. So let's start with the first topic of today's lecture, that is intermediate COCOMO model. As we have already discussed in a basic COCOMO model, it need a KLOC. Okay, so basic COCOMO model have some of the disadvantages, like basic COCOMO model does not use any different parameters for effort and cost estimation. Then it always have a KLOC for as a project size. Okay, so here the basic COCOMO model assume that efforts and development time depends on the product size alone. Okay, so if you have a product size, then you can easily calculate what is the development time and what is the effort for developing any software product. However, several parameters affect effort and development time. So parameters like reliability requirements, then availability of case tools and modern facility to be developed, size of the data to be handled. Okay, so there are also different parameters that affect your effort and development time. Okay, so that indirectly affect your software cost. So therefore, in order to obtain an accurate estimation of the effect and project duration, that means development time, the effect of all relevant parameters must be considered. So the intermediate COCOMO model recognizes this fact and refines the initial estimate. Okay, so it refines your requirements to obtain by the basic COCOMO using a set of 15 cost driver. Okay, so kind of multipliers based on the various attributes of software development. Okay, so it also uses basic COCOMO model for cost estimation, but it uses different 15 parameters to calculate the actual cost of your software product. So the 15 attributes or 15 parameters that consider for accurate project estimation, these are categorized into four categories, like product attributes, computer attributes, project attributes and personal attributes. Product attributes means required software reliability extreme, size of the application database and the complexity of the product. Okay, so here in product is reliable or not, what is the size of your database in your product and what is the complexity of your product. So these three parameters will help you to calculate the product attributes. Okay, so these are the parameters for product. Then computer attribute, like what is the overall performance, so runtime performance constraint. Then memory constraint, what is the actual memory. Then volatility of the virtual machine environment and required turnabout time. Okay, so these are the computer attributes, means these parameters consider for computer attributes. Then next is a personal attribute. Personal attribute means analyst capability. So if you have a system analyst or a software analyst, so what is the actual capacity of that particular analyst? Then software engineering capability. Okay, so what is the capability of your software engineers that you have to affect in your cost estimation? Application experience, if there is a person, then what kind of experience he or she had. Okay, then virtual machine experience and programming language experience. If you are going to develop any software in a Python language, but you do not have that particular Python language knowledge, then you just have to follow the Python programming language first. Okay, so you just need to study that language and then after you are able to develop any software in the Python programming language. Okay, so programming language experience. So these are some personal attributes, means personal parameters that consider for cost and effort estimation. Then next is a project attributes. Project attributes means use of software tools. Okay, so what kind of software tools that you are using for developing your software? Application of software engineers matter. So what kind of application you are using as a method? Okay, so which method you are using to develop any software? Then required development schedule. So you also need a requirement schedule, and for that purpose you need one person who schedule and track the all activities. Okay, so these are the parameters that directly or indirectly affect your cost estimation. Okay, so this parameter have a 5 different value. Okay, so each and every parameter have ranged from very low to very high. Okay, so very low, low, nominal, high and very high. So each and every 15 parameters have a unique value. So values are already predefined. So these are the product attribute, computer attributes, personal attributes and project attributes. Okay, so here all the attributes are mentioned, like in product attributes RELY, that is for reliability, then data, so what is the size of database, then CPLX for complexity. So these have a different value. So if your project is reliable at a very low, okay, so you need 0.75 value for calculation. Okay, so similarly, if your reliability is low, then 0.88, nominal then 1, high then 1.15 and for very high 1.40. Okay, so these are some parameters value that is predefined. Okay, so this is known as a estimation adjustment factor. Okay, so what kind of adjustment factor you need on your project, then you have to multiply all the factors. Okay, then you can calculate EAF. Okay, that we will discuss in our example. So these are the parameters and its value. Now, how to calculate intermediate COCOMO model? So you can see that normally basic COCOMO model we are considering effort and development time. So here formula is almost similar to the basic COCOMO model. Just in effort we are multiplying actual value with the EAF value. Okay, EAF means estimation adjustment factor. Okay, that 15 parameters, and then after, if you calculate efforts, then you can easily calculate the development time. So E is effort and D is your development time. The table that we have already discussed in a basic COCOMO model. Okay, so COCOMO cost estimation is about three type: organic, semi-detached and embedded. If your project is embedded or semi-detached or organic, then you have to take particular values for the constant. Okay, so AI, BI, CI and DM. So let's understand with the proper example. Example is like, for a given project was estimated with the size of 300k LOC. Okay, so here value is already given in a kilo lines of code. Okay, so value is 300k LOC. Okay, then you have to calculate the effort and development time. Okay, so schedule time for development by the considering developer having high application experience. Okay, so here one parameter is defined like very high experience of any application and very low experience in the programming language. So here in our example, two parameters are defined: application experience and programming language experience. Okay, so here application experience is very high and experience in programming is very low. So from the previous table, we are considering the value of AEXP, that is application experience, and LEXP, that is your language experience. Okay, so application experience is very high, so we will take 0.82, and for language experience very low, so 1.14. So it affects that particular kind of. Okay, so now multiplication of 0.82 and 1.14, so you can get a EAF value. So if there is a multiple parameter, then you have to multiply each and every parameter, so you will get one answer. So here answer is 0.9348. Now just put all the values into the effort. Okay, so effort is equal to A into KLOC power of B multiplication of EAF. Here we have selected semi-detached. Okay, so for semi-detached, constant value are 3, 1.12, 2.5 and 0.35. So A is 3, then KLOC is already given, that is 300, b value is 1.12 for semi-detached. So 1.12 multiplication of EAF value is 0.9348 that we have calculated. Okay, and now calculate this equation and you will get approximate effort time is like 1668.07 PM. PM means person month. You need this kind of efforts. Now calculate the development time. So for development time, we need C and D constant and we need effort. Okay, that we have already calculated. So put all the values into the formula and you will get 33.55 months. So you require approximate 34 months for completion of this particular software product. Okay, so this is the example of intermediate COCOMO model. Okay, so here not only just product size but different parameters are also considered for the accurate cost estimation. Now let's discuss the detailed COCOMO model. Okay, so detailed COCOMO model incorporates all characteristics of the intermediate version. Okay, so here intermediate characteristics are already considered. Okay, with an assessment of the cost drivers impact on each step of the software engineering process. So in our first lecture of unit 1, we have discussed about the SDLC. Okay, so software development lifecycle, there are various phases. Okay, like requirement gathering and analysis, then designing, then coding, then testing and maintenance. Okay, so detailed COCOMO model is about detail in each and every phase. Okay, so once you will get requirement, you will do analysis of the requirement. Okay, and then after you will finalize what are the actual requirements and then you will develop the further project. Okay, so here each and every phases is divided. So for each and every phase you are calculating the cost. Okay, so for requirement gathering you need a person. Okay, then for designing you need a software engineer, for coding purpose also, for testing you need a QA QC team, and for maintenance you need a maintenance team. Okay, so here each and every phases is calculated separately. The detailed model uses different efforts multiplier for each cost driver attribute. Okay, so these all 15 parameters that we have already discussed in an intermediate COCOMO model are considering each and every phases. Okay, so in detailed COCOMO, the whole software is divided into the different modules and then we apply COCOMO in different modules to estimate effort and then sum of the effort. Okay, so now you have done with the separate calculation and at the end you have to summarize all the thing. Okay, so addition of all the cost you will get a total cost of the software product. So this approach reduces the margin of error in the final estimate. So the six phases for detailed COCOMO are like planning and requirement. Okay, so all 15 parameters are resides in planning and requirement, system structure, complete structure, module code and test, integration and test, and last constructive cost model. Okay, so cost constructive model. So for each and every phase you require 15 parameters. You will calculate for each and every phase, each and every module, and then after you will calculate the grand total of your cost estimation. So let's understand with the proper example. Like if you have to develop a software like a management information system software for an organization having offices at several places across the country. Okay, for an example, we seen a many MNC company. Okay, so headquarters is with other places and many branches are there. Okay, so here you have to develop a management information system for an organization having offices at several places. Okay, for an example, there is a brand factory shop. Okay, in Ahmedabad. Okay, and at various location. So if brand factory shop or owner inform you to develop any software, so what you will do? They have a multiple branches across the Ahmedabad area. Okay, even in the Baroda and many other places. Okay, so all over the country, main head office is at a different place and many branches are there. Okay, so you have to manage all the branches from the one place. Okay, so what you will do? You will divide your whole project into the number of parts. So as you know that we require database part. Okay, so database part, then we need a GUI component, so GUI part, and for communication there is a communication part. Okay, so whole project is divided into a three part: database part, graphical user interface part, and the communication part. Here you already know the database part is a kind of medium scale. Okay, so semi-detached type of cost estimation. Okay, so it have a experienced and inexperienced person. Similarly, GUI is the basic. The designer can design anything if it, he or she have a proper skill. So we will use a organic type. And for communication, it is a very complex or a large. Okay, all the branches have a different parameters. All the branches have a different categories for fashion and clothes. Okay, so you will divide whole the project into the number of parts. Okay, now cost of the component are estimated separately. Okay, so you will calculate the cost for each and every part by considering that 15 parameters. Okay, now you have done with the separate calculation. At the end, you have to sum up the given the overall cost of the system. Okay, so now just calculate the summation of database part, GUI part and the communication part. So you will get the actual cost of your system. So this is about the detailed COCOMO model. In basic COCOMO model, we calculate the approximate amount. Okay, so what is the approximate cost? Then in intermediate, you are calculating about the different parameter. Okay, so you are considering different parameters. And in detail, you are calculating about the each and every phases and modules. Okay, so this is about the three stages of cost estimation. So that's all for the today's lecture. We have discussed about the intermediate COCOMO model and the detailed COCOMO model. Thank you.